Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here. And in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we are going to be solving the mystery of Emerald Ranch. You guys might not realize it, but there's something incredibly creepy going on at this settlement located in the Heartlands just east in New Hanover. So I'm sure you guys have all been to Emerald Ranch before, but if you haven't, it's a pretty well-kept property that's complete with a barnhouse, livestock, crops, gardens, and the owner is a man by the name of Eugene Wegner. That's important because there's details here that we're going to need to pick up on a little bit later. Now, there's a few main buildings in Emerald Ranch. The first is Mr. Wegner's house, which is a big part of the mystery we're going to be solving today. The next is a saloon that is no longer in operation. Two barnhouses, some residential homes for ranch workers, and like some areas where cows and other livestock would hang out. Now, if you interact with the people in the area, you'll sort of notice a different, more somber mood. The people in Emerald Ranch have a gloomy outlook on things. They sort of seem a little bit more depressed, and when they're talking to you, they're a little bit more hostile than normal folk. So I wonder why that is the case. In fact, a lot of the in-game dialogue often references the fact that Mr. Wegner, who is the owner of Emerald Ranch, is incredibly unfriendly and has a very mysterious background. Now, probably the biggest and most mysterious part of Emerald Ranch is actually the second floor of the Wegner's house. So at noon and at midnight every single day, although I might have had a little bit of a glitch because this was happening to me way before noon, you'll actually see Mr. Wegner's daughter come to the window, and she won't do anything. She'll just stand there staring, looking out, sort of fixing her hair, touching her face, and that is all she does. Now, we actually find out that her name is Miriam, and we know that Miriam is the daughter of Eugene Wegner, but we don't know at this moment why she is inside the house and why she only appears at noon and at midnight before ultimately retreating back inside. Now, the game itself does a pretty good job of giving us some backstory on Emerald Ranch. However, it's not one that we'll come across naturally. Now, I discovered some really good details through a random encounter. There was this woman whose horse had died on the side of the road, and she actually asked for a ride back to Emerald Ranch. And if you assist her, she'll tell you some of the backstories behind the area. So take a listen to this conversation right here that you have with the woman as you're giving her a ride back to Emerald Ranch.
You know Emerald Ranch? Mind taking me there?
So, you live at Emerald Ranch then?
For the time being. I was looking for work. They was looking for some help with the gardens. If I waited any longer for my husband to put food on the table, I'd have died of starvation. I'll be moving on soon, though. Emerald Ranch, well, it's a strange place.
How so?
The owner's a mean bastard. Strange, too. Delights in bullying folk. There's a daughter, but she never leaves the house. You can see her in the window sometimes. When I asked about her, everybody told me to leave it alone. Found an old saloon there, all shut down now. But I went in to have a look, and there's bullet holes, old blood stains. Something definitely happened there, but I couldn't figure it. Just an uncomfortable feeling to the place. Either way, it's time I left, especially now I lost that poor horse. I'll collect my belongings and be on my way.
So that gave us a lot of details right there, and that is pretty cool. So the first thing that this lady brings up is the saloon. She mentions that the saloon has been closed for some time now after it seems to have been home to a murder scene. However, the door is unlocked so we can actually go inside. However, upon entering, you'll actually see blood stains on the floor to the left of the bar. Now, in that same area, you'll also see broken glass, and there looks to have been some sort of fight or struggle. Now, there also seems to be three bullet holes on the far wall to the right of the back door, and the bullet holes are in the shape of a triangle. Now, I also realized that they seem to be taller than the normal person. I don't know how tall Arthur is. He seems like a pretty tall guy, and the bullet holes are above that. So whoever was shot had to have been pretty tall, or they were bad shots. So we'll come back to that in a little bit. There's also some missing paintings from the wall, and it just looks like it's been abandoned for a couple months now, at least a couple of years. Now, there's also a couple of interesting things about this saloon. There's actually some inaccessible parts of it, like there's locked doors that you can't get access to. There's definitely a back room there, but we can't get access inside. Now, the lady also gives us more details on Miriam Wegner. She discusses how Miriam has stayed inside Eugene's house for an extended period of time, but she also mentioned that the daughter used to go outside frequently when she was younger, but has since kept herself indoors. And last but not least, she mentions that Miriam can be seen through the window, which we're watching right now. Now, something that's interesting to note and that I wanted to try, what would happen if you actually shot at Miriam? What would she do? And like most normal people, you can shoot at her. However, the glass is bulletproof, but doing so, she will end up retreating inside of the house. So doing that actually scares her away. Now, we can actually get some more information on Miriam. If we actually find this abandoned mail cart near Fort Wallace, there's a couple of letters in there. However, the one we're interested in has been addressed to Mr. Wegner's daughter. The note says, "Letter to Miriam Wegner, a letter from a loving cousin." And it says this, "My dearest Miriam, I have decided that I would write you again because even though our world seems so far apart these days, I think of you often. New York is crowded and dirty, but so alive. It feels like anything is possible, even for a country girl like me. And my biggest news is that I have been cast in Henrik Ibsen play. It's a small role, but I can now finally call myself a Broadway actress. Sometimes I do miss home, though the peace and clean air, being able to take a ride at first light. I received a letter from Lily Millett a while back, and it appears that she is experiencing some financial difficulties. I'm worried that Weasel Cooper has his claws in her again. She also mentioned that she has not seen you leave the house in months. I cannot begin to imagine how painful it must have been for you to lose Joshua in such a horrible way. And I would never assume to instruct you on how to grieve, but I worry about you existing in such isolation. This must be the sixth letter I have sent to you with no response. Please let me know that you are all right. Even if it's just the shortest of notes to tell me to mind my own business, you can tell me anything. Your loving cousin, Annabelle. P.S. Uncle Eugene, with the greatest respect, if you are withholding my mail for Miriam, or dare I say, constraining her in any other way, I beg you to reconsider your actions. I know how much you love her, but please do not confuse love with possession. She is a beautiful, intelligent woman with so much life ahead of her." Wow. So it seems as if Miriam has been trapped inside of this house, what looks to be at the will of her father, Eugene. And this is the sixth letter that Annabelle has sent with absolutely no response. Now, we also get details on a new character to this mystery, and that is Joshua. Joshua was probably a lover of Miriam, and it looks like Joshua died in a tragic accident. Is what happened at the saloon the fate that came about Joshua Burgess? And who ended up killing him? That is kind of interesting. What's also interesting is directly outside of the saloon, we can actually see a grave for Joshua Burgess as well. And that grave has a very sarcastic sort of heading on there. It says, "Accidentally shot August 1898. That is like super disrespectful. Accidentally shot. To me, that sounds like someone that killed someone, but they didn't really like him, and you know, they say to themselves, oh, he was accidentally shot in a dispute. So here are the theories that I can come up with as far as what's happening at Emerald Ranch, especially after obtaining that letter in the mail cart. I think it insinuates that Miriam had a lover named Joshua Burgess, who was the person that was killed in the saloon. Now, I can assume that Mr. Wegner probably did not approve of his daughter's lover and had him killed, which is why we see the accident at the saloon and the headstone saying he was accidentally shot, and there being three bullet holes in the wall. So after that, I would assume that the father locked his daughter in his house because he cannot trust her with any more men, and that is why the letters are no longer reaching her. Now, there's a couple of other theories as well that make sense. Number one, Emerald Ranch seems to be a very, very strange place. In fact, Seamus, the guy who owns the fence at Emerald Ranch, could have actually murdered Joshua Burgess as well. During one of the main missions, Hosea mentions that Seamus was sweet for the owner's daughter. So could Seamus have actually murdered Joshua Burgess in hopes to have getting with the owner's daughter? That's another possible theory right there. Now, what's also very strange is apparently you can get inside the house and you can get Miriam to go outside. This is coming from Reddit user CRuins, who posted these two photos right here. He said that both of these were done with glitches. This first photo, you can see that he is inside of the house. You can simply see Miriam here staring outside like she would if you were outside of the house. And then he said he was able to get her outside of the house as well. And you can just see her walking down sort of the hill. Now, according to CRuins, he said it was done all through glitches and it doesn't add anything to the story. She doesn't say anything aside from a few generic NPC lines. So that is quite strange. Now, the only other interesting thing I found of note in Emerald Ranch is there was this one sort of secret mission that I got. So I was trying to help this guy find his dog. He said his dog ended up running off, and wouldn't you know that the dog ends up hiding underneath the saloon, the one where the murder apparently took place and right where the tombstone actually is. And upon returning this guy's dog, he is a total jerk to the dog. Like, he wants to start kicking it and beating it and just doing terrible things, and the dog wants to run away. So there's a clear reason why the dog is hiding in the first place, and there's also no way to interact with this guy after you basically confront him for being a rude jerk to his dog. So I think this just adds fuel to the fire that the people of Emerald Ranch are quite strange, and there is just something very, very weird going on here. But I do think the mystery has ultimately been solved. Now, I'm sure you guys are going to be wondering, is Miriam the missing Princess Isabeau? And I think the answer to that is no. I also think we know that she is choosing to stay in the house by choice, but that her father definitely has a strong influence on what goes on here. And it looks like there was a murder that took place of one of her lovers. So I think that solves the mystery, but as always, I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Do you have any other details to share with us here today? And do you think that my theory is correct on what happened at Emerald Ranch? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.